F working? I might have fucked up the head. I was just letting know people real quick. I was trying to fuck with some people real quick before we get started. But you can roll it.
You got a trip again. Yeah, you can.
So you know what Jews you lose? Did you know that?
Damn, that shit.
Yo, Chinese bitch, come here.
She an Israelite. They know.
Come on, let's go.
That's your boy. That who's at the drunk hired? Come on, let's go. I bet he got arrested for rape or something. That dude right here, he touched me, guys. You got any scriptures left for you?
Bring it out.
You got some. Hey, go ahead.
But in Venezuela, many basic food goods are in short supply. The government blames America and Europe, which says are out to destroy its economy. Others say the government has brought the problems on itself. But on the whole, Venezuela is more like Britain with its lineups. The difference is that Venezuela, they're not waiting for the 29 bus. They're lined up for milk, coffee, sugar, corns, flour.
That's a socialist country, too. Yeah, Venezuela, you know, they got one of the highest murder rates in the world down there. It's all Israelites. They're a bunch of ruthless killers down there. Okay. But this is coming to America, too, though. It's already started. Go ahead.
Sugar, corn, flour, cooking oil, soup, and soap, and even toilet paper. All short supply.
Toilet paper and short supply. None of them fat bitches will wash their ass. Yeah, so yeah, you got Venezuela. I mean, the whole world's going to shit. Now you got America going to shit. You got the riots popping off over there in Baltimore. First it was Ferguson. Now the same script that was followed in Ferguson's being played out over Baltimore. The same script, the same actors, you know what I'm saying? Exactly the same people protesting in Ferguson is in Baltimore, okay? Because the powers that be, the so-called elite of the world, they have engineered.
Oh, there goes your homie down there.
So they have engineered this so-called crisis. They want the elite, they want these riots to pop off, so they can divide and conquer you fools and install martial law. Because you got a lot of these fools down there, they think they're going to riot. And they're going to think they're going to get some kind of justice. You ain't get no justice. You're going to get martial law, you dumbass. But that's good for you. You deserve to be put in concentration camps. Because soon that's what they're going to do. They're going to install martial law. And if you don't go along with the martial law, you're going right into a concentration camp. And that's what's coming. Concentration camps, race riots, and it's all engineered by the so-called Jew. The so-called Jew, devil, Satan, they're the ones behind all of it. That's why the mainstream media, they always pushing all this racial shit. Every day in the news, is all everything's about race. They trying to fume the flames of the race war. But that's what's coming. And we've been prophesying for years and years that race wars was coming. We've been out here teaching for over 6 years, telling y'all race wars is coming. And people, y'all full of shit, it ain't never gonna happen. Well, now it's here. Now there's race wars. Like all you little weak little white people, you gonna get beat up, okay? You gonna get your teeth stomped in. You gonna get beat up, hit in the face with a brick, ran over with a car, ate to death by pit bulls, beat up by a mob of 30 niggas. They just gonna beat the shit out you. They gonna take your wallet and just leave you for dead. And that's what you deserve. All these faggot ass white people, they deserve that, man. And these jakes, all these so-called black people getting beat up by the cops, they deserve that too. Y'all know race wars is coming, right? You know the race wars is already here. What y'all gonna do when you getting this shit beat out of you? Or we gonna laugh at you. We gonna laugh at you.
This guy don't stand a chance.
Yeah, they don't stand a chance. All these little limp-wristed weaklings, these white people, a bunch of faggots. Okay, so they gonna get the shit beat out of them. Yeah, more than that. I'm sorry. I just wanted. I've been watching all the videos on the Baltimore riots. It's beautiful. Shit just burning up in flames. It's beautiful, man. You know what I'm saying? The scriptures be following perfectly.
You're going to have to run faster than that.
It's going right according to plan. Because all these race wars and riots, the sedition, this shit got to come. This is all prophecy. We've been telling people about this for years.
I got him getting broke.
You got him? It's not even slick. Who the fuck does tricks on scooters? Well, he gonna take a scooter on the half pipe? I mean, where did he do that at? A scooter? It's like that Razor scooter video game.
Look, he about to go again after getting broke.
Jackass on camera, man. He's gonna get fucked up. Oh, he hit it. Almost. He almost got it. Trying to steal our shine.
He got a pink scooter at that.
That's a purple scooter.
Same difference.
It's a light purple. It is nearing pink. It is almost pink. Okay. He's almost there. He's almost a total faggot.
Look at these shades of purple.
Ned, give
my
ID to piss?
Yep.
You scared?
I think they recognize. I think we just recognized
him. Where'd you go? UDF?
No, it's a place right there.
God damn. You can't take a piss out here. They won't let you. If you want to take a piss in the bathroom at Taco Bell, you gotta get a code, a computer code. You gotta get a goddamn password to get up in that motherfucker. But if you get caught pissing out in the streets, they get him, give you a ticket. You know what I'm saying? This is a guy, only the damn devil would set it up so you can't even take a piss. Oh yeah, we already started talking about Baltimore. You know I had to talk about Baltimore. Like I said, we've been telling people the race wars has come for years. And now it's finally here. And now we laughing at you fools, man. Everybody's bugging out. A lot of my friends, I was telling them about it. They didn't want to believe it. Now they bugging out. Oh, you was right. Oh, that's amazing. But now it's going to be too late for y'all to get this truth again. They only want to listen to the truth when they start to get all scared and hell breaking. Hell starts breaking out, you know what I mean? You know, it's just like when attacks on 9/11 happened. Nobody cared about the Bible, but when the attacks on 9/11 happened, everybody started buying Bibles. Bible sales shot through the roof. These people ain't fucking right, man. What if the Bible says you gotta seek me early? Oh man, I forgot my fucking phone. Damn it, I hope nobody fucking steals it. Kids. That'd be alright. We got tinted windows. Look, I'm going to fucking. Did I lock my shit up? I think I did. I pray to the Most High, it'd be alright. What you got? What you got? Damn, man.
Venezuelans could soon have to scan their fingerprints to buy bread.
Oh shit. Scan their fingerprints to buy bread. That's biometrics. That's just a precursor to the microchip, RFID. Because they already do that. If you go, you know, when you go to get an ID at the BNB now, when they take your picture for when you get an ID, they put your face into the computer, your picture, and they get a... They do biometrics on your face, and they use facial recognition software, and they put your picture into a database, and then they link that up with your Facebook page. You know what I'm saying? You got some leaves and shit hanging off your head.
Yes.
What's up, y'all?
Yes. The synagogue of Satan.
You know about the synagogue of Satan? No, the so-called Jew is the devil. Did you know that?
Because they don't get baptized. They don't believe in baptism.
They believe in, they don't believe, they worship Satan.
They don't. They worship Yahweh.
Who's Yahweh?
Yahweh is their God.
Jewish circumcision.
They don't worship. They don't worship the God of the Bible.
The Old Testament. Yeah, they do.
No, they don't. They follow the Talmud.
Well,
you know what the Talmud is?
Yeah, it's one of their books. So it's the Torah.
Hey, give me Revelation 2 and 9.
I mean, I've read the Bible back and front.
Well, what does Revelation 2 and 9 say?
I don't have it fucking memorized.
Well, you read the Bible, though. You should know it.
Yeah, I read it like in my youth. I don't
know. Well, I'll read it right here, bro. Let me read it to you real quick.
I'm like good on your anti-Semitism, bro.
What's that? What does Semite mean? You don't even know what it means. Why don't you say anti-Jew instead of anti-Semite? But why would you say anti-Jew instead of anti-Semite?
Nor are we American. You know, but the both of those names are names of heathens. They're not Israelites.
You're speaking of heathens.
A goddamn non believer. A non believer.
What's up, heathens? How y'all heathens doing?
Well, okay, see, that's a heathen's thinking.
Yeah,
well, that's a heathen thinking. No, you denying it. Well, you ain't denying it because it ain't given to you in the first fucking place. That's why you got all this shit sticking out your face.
You look like you talking about my shit sticking out my face.
What about it?
I have the free will to do whatever
that's
the hell
right.
I want.
Free will to be a goddamn fool. To be
a fool.
Yeah, I'm calling you a fool.
Hey, that's my brother.
Okay, but anyway, listen. Okay, these people that
you look like you run a That 70s Show.
You ain't African. The people that's African.
That's what's your boy's name? What's your dude's name that took over Charlie Sheen?
Ashton Kutcher.
That's Ashton Kutcher's little cousin.
Okay, but he was reading Revelation 2 and 9.
Revelation 2 and 9. I know thy works of tribulation, poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews. Keep going.
And are not.
And are not.
N-O-T.
Keep going.
They are the synagogue of Satan.
They're synagogue of Satan. A rabbi.
You know, there's proof that there was religion before God.
We don't have a religion.
This ain't religion right here.
You don't have a religion?
Oh, no, we ain't got no religion. You
are.
This is truth.
We got truth. We got truth, not religion.
Truth is in the eyes.
Religion is bullshit. We got truth.
This is spiritual ride right here.
Truth is in the eyes of the whole.
Hold on, bro.
If you guys believe to be truth, to be someone
else,
Hold on.
Let me ask you a question.
Is this true? Okay, so, when do y'all go to church?
We in church right now.
You guys are in church right now.
This
okay.
is church. What is the church? I get Acts 7 and 4.
What does the church say? The church says that God says...
The church is a bunch of faggots.
But you say you're in church right now.
No, I'm talking about these churches out here in the world. With Pastor Porkchop and Pastor Chitlins up in there lying to everybody.
Pastor Chitlins?
Yeah, Pastor Chitlins, Pastor Porkchop.
Okay. Deacon Nolo.
Yeah. Oh, like your boy. What's your boy that was raising money for a jet airplane?
Oh, Creflo Dollar.
Like Creflo Dollar.
Boston Marathon, Sandy Hook, Aurora.
For the dollar.
U.S. government are terrorists.
They are terrorists.
Well, I agree with that part. I'm just not sure what you're trying to accomplish with this part. I definitely agree with that.
Would that make us terrorists? Would that make all of us terrorists then?
I mean, you realize Jesus was a Jew, right?
Hold on.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
true.
You guys pay taxes?
Well, here it is. Wait.
He was a black man.
Do you guys pay taxes?
It's debatable. There's no evidence to suggest who he was.
There is evidence.
If the government or Jews, wouldn't that make us all Jews? Because the creator of the government says we the people. The government is made out of us.
All right, you were talking about the... All right, what the Declaration of Independence said, we get our freedom from God.
We do get our freedom from God, but the thing
not
is...
Not from the government.
The thing is, the way that y'all talk about it...
You ain't been here for 5 minutes. You don't know what's going on.
You don't know nothing about it yet. You ain't heard shit yet.
Hey, read that Acts 7:48.
There you go. You guys are going to like this. Look at this.
Oh.
Hail Satan. Satan loves you.
You don't even know what upside down cross represents.
Yeah, it's St. Peter actually, but it's also, you know, just a way to piss people off, especially Christians.
I'm agnostic, so I'm not a Christian or anything.
I'm not fucking
Christian. What is agnostic? Religion. Agnostic means that you believe in a God, not just one.
That's not what it means.
Agnostic is agnostic there might means, be a God, but there is no
agnostic
proof.
Means without knowledge. Literally.
It means not Gnostic. Gnostic means enlightened.
No, it means not knowledge. No. It means without knowledge.
No, that would be acknowledgeable, not agnostic.
Gnosis means knowledge. So agnostic means without knowledge.
Well, it means
against knowledge.
Knowledge.
It means
spiritual knowledge.
It means you admit that not knowing shit.
Essentially. Oh, I know a lot.
All I feel
like
is
not knowing shit, but not knowing
like
what.
You guys are doing is insulting everyone in government.
We are insulting people.
Insulting
everyone. It's our job to insult people. We enjoy it. We have a good time insulting people. I enjoy it.
One of these days, you guys are going to end up real fucked up.
We already fucked up.
I mean, you're already, like, right here on here in Columbus on those two campuses. Someone might drive by and throw bricks.
We've been out here for over 6 years, bro.
Someone might drive by and throw bricks.
Don't matter if you're out here 6 days, 6 years, 6 decades.
Act 7.
I've never had the Bible read to me before, guys. You're enlightening me. I only live in fucking America where I'm force fed Jewish religion.
I'll be the Most High dwelleth not in temples.
And you don't even know about it.
Okay, listen.
I'll be it.
Listen, this is important.
Yeah, if y'all just. We can kick
it. I also like the part where it says to dash children on rocks and that women are.
That's Edomite children. Edomite children. Edomite children. We'll get to that. That's a good point, though. That's a very good point.
How old are you, man?
Is that a Bible?
Read this.
How old are you?
16.
Listen.
Actually, listen for a second, all right?
Acts 7 and 48.
So we'll stop trolling and we'll teach you. Listen.
Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands.
The Most High does not dwell in temples made with hands. Keep going.
Hey, I'm going to go have a blood orgy. Fuck your weak God.
Go ahead. Do your thing, man. Devil's in his kingdom.
Yeah, hell Satan.
You're supposed to do what you
want. He said hell Satan.
You guys... But you and you said you guys aren't religious.
So you guys would rather hang out.
We're spiritual men.
Let me ask you a question.
That's right. What's that mean?
But you just said fuck religion.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't have religion. I was not a hypocrite.
Fuck religion, yet you read out of the Bible.
Well, where did the one you call Jesus say,
I don't believe
be a religious guy?
I don't believe in Jesus.
Oh, okay. So no wonder we cursing you out.
So you're an antichrist.
That's the spirit working.
Cuss me, I don't care.
That means you got demons on you.
Everybody got demons in them. I want one of y'all to tell me that you have never sinned. I want one of y'all to tell me.
We never said that.
There's very few people that don't have demons in them.
There is not a sinless person. My grandfather.
That's true, too. That's
everybody
true.
Has demons.
That is so true. But you don't believe in the Bible, so why are you quoting shit out of the Bible?
Because my grandfather's a pastor.
He's a pastor. You probably don't know shit. Well, he's a pastor. That's the result of your grandfather being a pastor.
That's his proof of result.
That motherfucker obviously went to Israel because he didn't teach you how to
pray. That's my grandfather. No, you guys are showing the deadly sin of wrath.
Show me the scripture of the deadly sin of wrath. Show me that scripture.
Show you what? The seven deadly sins? Oh, wait!
Seven
time
deadly
out.
Sins.
Time out!
What you watch?
A lot of spiritual people put on the seven deadly sins.
You watch the movie
in
seven.
The Bible. Are you serious?
You watching Hollywood movies.
Hollywood movies.
Listen, young man. Let me read this. Let me read the scripture.
Read the scripture.
This is Ephesians 6 and 19.
So let me tell you something.
Listen,
I'm not going to go by the Bible. You want to know why?
Because
you're
a
non-believer.
I'm the devil. Oh, my God. I'm Lucifer himself.
And for me, that utterance may be given unto me that I may open my mouth boldly.
Who wrote the Bible?
To make known the mysteries of the gospel.
Who wrote the Bible?
For which I am an ambassador in bonds, that therein I may speak boldly I ought to speak.
So who wrote the Bible?
So who wrote the Bible then?
Matthew, Mark, Luke, John.
Okay, so show me Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Job, the Ephesians. Show me all of them. Where are they at right now?
We're right here.
Y'all ain't no damn Matthew, Mark, John. Y'all ain't none of them. You're not none of them.
You told them not to question nobody. And you bar Jesus.
I bar Jesus.
You bar Jesus,
bro. Can I record you?
You're
recording
you. You could very well be bar Jesus in the reincarnation. You know what I'm saying?
Call me the Antichrist.
Yo. Get Proverbs 13 and 13.
2 Peter 2 and 12. But these as natural brute beasts made to be taken and destroyed. Speak evil of the things that they understand not.
You speaking evil of things that you understand not.
So
you know what I'm saying? No, we're not. We out here.
You know what y'all look like to me, bro? Y'all look like the people who be on the streets just wanting to be heard, wanting to be, just want to scream everything so people can show you. You guys are attention seekers.
We are attention seekers.
But you see how many people pass you by every day because what y'all speaking right now is a bunch of bullshit.
Of course, to you, what
poor excuses, bro, for people to listen to y'all.
Many are called
because y'all have it hard, because y'all give up on yourselves.
What did the one you called Jesus say? Many are called, but
I don't
you
call no one
are
Jesus.
Chosen.
I don't call
you. What does the word
no
few mean?
One Jesus.
Let me read this. This is Matthew 13 and 19. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh the wicked one.
Satan. I know, ladies.
They homie already said
you know?
Yeah.
Like,
got an upside down cross.
The women, bro. The women.
And cometh the wicked one
the
and
women.
Away that
are you married?
Sown in his heart.
Are you married, sir?
This
are you
is
married?
He which receiveth seed by the wayside.
Are you married?
Ain't none of your goddamn business. I'm married.
Are you married?
Yeah, I'm married to the Most High. And we out here to bid people to the marriage. We out here to wake up the lost sheep of the house of Israel
trying
and get them to the marriage.
Trying to.
Yeah.
I trying can, to.
Look around.
Proverbs 13.
Oh,
know
I got that. I got that. Proverbs 13 and 13.
No
who
one cares.
So despises
no
the word shall be destroyed.
Read it again.
No one cares.
Who
read me Psalms 23.
Despises the word shall be destroyed.
Whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed.
Strike me down. Darn.
No, that's the first time we've ever heard that.
What,
your originality is stunning.
Oh, yeah, you know what?
I'm
dang
still here. You're the same
I'm
demon. We done met the same demon that you possessed by thousands of times.
I'm not possessed by shit except free will.
Just
16,
dude.
No,
what are you doing out here?
You are a program rat.
How old are you?
I'm 16.
The Bible 16? Says, remember thy creator from the days of thy youth.
Y'all should go home and take a shower and bath, man, and stop kissing on each other.
Don't need to go home and take a shower and bath.
You need to quit.
They over there scatting and skeeting on each other.
Right, right.
Trying to talk about the damn word.
You
like fucking shot the school, bro. Why don't you get off
the
street and go get a
against
job,
the evil
bro.
Work. It's not executed.
Shower.
Out of a book that human beings wrote, bro.
Okay.
Show me Matthew. Show
that's
me
why you was over here looking to hear the word, right?
Y'all ain't no damn...
Show me the book that
fucking
Jesus himself wrote.
Scoffers.
Show me the book Jesus wrote. Show me the book Jesus Christ wrote with his own hands. The Messiah. Show me the book Jesus of Nazareth wrote. Let me see it. Let me see it. Come on.
Okay,
come
this
on.
Is 2 Peter
on,
3
me.
And 3.
Show me the
knowing this
show
earth,
me Jesus
that there shall
hand
come
hand
in the last days
show
scoffers.
Me
scoffers.
Jesus
walking
hand
after their own lusts.
They I got their own lusts.
Insane. Where is the promise of
show
his coming?
Show me Jesus' handwriting.
Yes.
The promise.
Coming right out the Bible, man.
He's well, walking around with a little ass. Christ he got a fifth grader Pokemon book bag.
I know.
What,
right?
You gonna throw a Pokeball at us?
Right.
You know what
right
I'm saying? You gonna try to trap me in a Pokeball? Is that what's going on?
Yeah, you guys wanna have that. There's like the weakest Pokemon.
Bro, they ain't your weakest Pokemon. They're the lowest level of human beings themselves.
That's what they said about the prophets.
They're scum.
Ain't that what they said about the
people? What did I mention, y'all? Y'all came out of...
They're cannon fodder, bro.
They came straight out
of
trans-dimensional vortex.
There's the earth.
Yeah.
The wind started
yeah
blowing.
Yeah. Right now.
These motherfuckers come falling out of.
So
check
right
out your boy's
bro
hair.
Excuse us, so let us go take a shower and bathe each other's blood.
They look like...
We got places to be. We got places to be on, like, sitting on the corner.
Get the fuck out.
Let's get a step in there.
Get the fuck out my face, goddammit.
Get a step in, man.
The sewage, where they take sewage
you
the garbage.
You came out of a
you're
sewer.
You're going the
get
right way. We're on the south side.
Get him
on there. You and you.
Look at your
hair.
Look at your hair, bro.
I don't
want to
hear you guys.
Bitch-ass faggots.
Yeah, you walk around with a little-ass Pokemon book bag.
Garbage Pail Kids. I think there was
some
call
fuck up, you little bitch. You little bitch ass monkey motherfucker.
Get him on camera. What'd you say?
Bitch, bro.
I can't
you
hear
a little bitch.
Speak up. Speak up. You sound like a pinkweed. I can't hear you.
You
put some bass in your voice.
Get the fuck out my face, you little bitch ass.
Prove to me I'm a bitch. boot me up, hey, a bitch. I just heard Jesus gave me the permission to fuck you up.
Let's do it. Do it. I'm right here.
Prove to me I'm a bitch, bro. Prove to me I'm a bitch. Come on, I'm right here. Prove to me I'm a bitch.
I ain't doing
I'm
shit.
I'm right here.
I'm right here.
Prove to me I'm a bitch, bro. Prove to me I'm a bitch. Come on. Come on, Jesus. Jesus talking to you right now. Prove to me I'm a bitch.
You ain't going to do shit. Get the fuck out of my face, you old bitch. You are a bitch.
I'm a bitch.
Come on,
Devils,
go.
Prove to me I'm a bitch.
Come on, man, go get
a
step, man.
Prove to me I'm a bitch.
Get the like fuck out of here, man. You little munchkin. You little piece of shit.
Prove to me I'm a piece of shit, then.
I ain't got to prove shit. You know deep down in your soul you are.
Cockeyed bastard. Deep down in my soul. Shut the fuck
little
up.
Little faggot.
You listening, fuck it. You looking in 180 degrees.
You wearing a, five-year-old Pokemon bastard. Book bag, bro.
You're
wearing nothing but rag. With a half a mohawk.
Rag, bro.
Oh, you're not?
Like you went to someone's grandma's house and took their quilt.
Yeah.
Come on now. Stop stealing people's grandma's quilts. Nigga,
look
do
at,
something.
Look at your
get
hair,
better,
bro.
Get up. I don't care.
You got
I'm
half
black.
A mohawk.
I'm black. I got half a
you
mohawk.
You couldn't finish the whole mohawk.
Yup, you're right.
You know what I'm saying?
But let me tell you
with
something.
Rusted ass
at
flippers.
The end of the day, at the end
shut
of the day.
Shut the fuck up. Get the fuck out of
make
here.
Make me shut up. What? Make me shut up, nigga.
I ain't going to make you do
make
shit.
Me shut up.
Get the fuck
make
out my face.
Make me shut up. Make me shut up. Nigga, make me shut up.
You ain't gonna do shit.
Make me shut up. Yeah, you ain't doing shit but being a little bitch with a camera, nigga.
That's right.
Fuck up with all that,
and you
nigga.
You gonna get to stepping.
Bitch.
And we ain't gonna see you no more.
You ain't gonna do shit.
I'll cut you, motherfucker.
Get the fuck out of here, you little bitch ass.
Prove to me I'm a bitch, bro.
I ain't gotta do shit.
Prove to me I'm a bitch, bro.
You gonna walk away and you gonna prove you a bitch because you ain't gonna do shit.
I'm right here.
I'll stay right
I'm not walking away.
You acting like an emotional female, man. You acting like an emotional
prove
woman.
Prove me I'm a bitch, bro.
You know.
Prove me I'm a bitch, bro.
It does say in the scriptures that effeminates will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. An effeminate.
Oh, you are sexist
and it's
now,
these,
aren't you?
It's these women
you're
that have an emotional response.
You're sexist.
It's these women.
Hey, these guys are right. These guys are sexist against women. You are y'all gay?
Saying?
Cause y'all sound sexist against women.
Gay, you're the one wearing a tight ass book
sure
bag.
I am,
and
bro.
You hanging out with that 70s
show. I'm not talking
show.
To you. I'm talking to your little friend right here who still hasn't proven that I'm a bitch.
Boy, look like
he said I was gonna walk away.
Look like the retarded Ashton Kutcher.
Kutcher,
dude.
You know, Ashton Kutcher, the same guy who was voted America's hottest man, right? So, prove that I'm a bitch, sir. Prove that I'm a bitch.
You got a problem with gays?
Let's record this.
Yeah, why don't y'all cut? Why don't y'all take y'all word and go down there?
Six and nine.
Down there.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God?
So if you are being unrighteous, y'all saying the Bible's a fairy tale. You saying the Bible's bullshit. So you ain't not, you're not gonna inherit the kingdom, okay? Keep going.
Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
Yeah, that means homosexuals. You know what I'm saying? Get him on camera. He got his knife out. Look at him. He got he's gonna shank somebody.
He can bring it out all he want. He ain't gonna do shit with it.
But doesn't it say something in the Bible about doing something against the body? The body's a sanctuary. Oh, then I must be sending the locks. I'm cutting myself up. I must be sending to the maxes. I must be sitting in the max. God,
we don't
want to
talk to you. We don't want
to
talk to you.
The sanctuary with just my body.
Then you go down there and go somewhere down there. Uh-huh. That way you ain't got to see us no more.
Uh-huh. Okay. Don't nobody want to see y'all. Y'all
good to leave.
Hey, bro, what's
we
up?
We got nothing to talk to you about.
What's up, bro? Hey, bro.
1 Corinthians 3:16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you? If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
Woo!
For the temple of God is holy.
That's one time right there.
Which temple ye are.
Yeah, so you over there, he cutting himself, pulling a knife out on us. You know what I'm saying?
You want to keep talking shit?
What you gonna do, man? You gonna do something? You gonna stab somebody?
Oh, these motherfuckers don't realize. They don't realize shit.
Actually, we've been threatened, so we'd be in the right if we just beat you down. You know what I'm saying?
I'm telling you, I'm gonna follow your ass.
Yeah, we will follow you. You know what I'm saying? We'd be in the right too. That's self protection.
Pull it out again.
You threaten us with knives and shit.
Pull it out again.
If you threaten me with a knife, I have the right to kill you, and I would get in no trouble. But you can get arrested right now for pulling a knife out of him.
You're following the government.
Man, you better back up off me, bro.
Beat this motherfucker's ass.
You threatened me with a weapon, bro. You better back up off me, man.
You out here threatening people like you gonna stab somebody. You better back up off me, bro.
What are you gonna do?
Don't come near me. You already threatened me, bro. So you come near me, I have the right to protect myself. Okay? And we will beat you to a bloody pulp. And you're going to have to stab me then, all right? I'm trying to be spiritual.
You're going
to
be sleeping.
We didn't threaten you with violence. Your boy pulled a knife out, and now you threaten me with a knife. And, all because we read you scriptures, all because the Bible cut you.
That's all right. That's
well, you ain't going to... Bro, you... Y'all threaten people with violence, bro. You're going to pull a knife out on somebody like a... That's what some cowards would do. Only a coward will pull out a weapon. A coward. We ain't got weapons on us. Okay? This only sword we got is this Bible. Is this Bible? Give me a Hebrews 4:12, bro.
I'm totally disappointed. Yep. Man.
Give me Hebrews 4:12. Don't even come near us, bro. Read me Hebrews 4:12. Yeah, get to stepping. Read Hebrews 4:12.
You talking shit when niggas walk, but you don't say shit with people in your face.
Motherfucker, you pulled a knife out on
me. I was like,
you
pulled
a knife, you ain't gonna do shit.
Hebrews 4:12. The word of God is quick, powerful, powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword.
So the reason they get offended today, they got offended by the word. Because they know they some demons, you know what I'm saying? Read it again.
The word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. Piercing even to the body asunder of soul, the spirit, and of the joints of marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts.
And it's funny, he said we talking shit while they walking away, but they're the ones talking shit walking away.
Right, right.
And then he walked away talking shit.
Man, anybody
then
know.
Then he came back and pulled a knife out of
right,
us.
Right, anybody know that anybody that know anything about going to a fight, man, you don't expose yourself.
You don't say shit, you just do it.
You just do it.
Right.
Well, I mean, we ain't afraid of them clowns, man. We just making a point.
I would have told.
Because we would have been in the, he pulled a knife, we would have been in the right if we would just beat him to a bloody pulp.
Beat him down, right.
And we would got in no trouble. That's self-defense. You know what I'm saying?
Ooh, the knife sound damn.
He got a big-ass knife, too.
Nice.
We ain't scared of a motherfucker with a knife. You can pull a gun out on me, bro. I'm still not going to be scared. You ain't see his takeoff running? He's right here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's how much people hate us. And they want to kill us. Right. You know what I'm saying?
I'm tired of shit.
He deserved to get put to death for that, man. And he gonna get put to death. The Lord gonna kill that motherfucker.
You mark the shit out of him. I'm tired of this shit, man. Living amongst these ungodly ass rats, man. I'm tired of this shit, man.
And they can walk around and do shit like that.
Yep. I mean, you know, hey, the scripture's all over again. You know, we're just living the past all over again.
Yep. Hey, let's get that scripture on Stephen. What's that, Acts 5th chapter?
Yeah, that's some good shit right there.
Stevens didn't give a goddamn. They killed him. He cursed their ass out all the way to the death. You know what I'm saying? Cause we didn't come out here saying we was gonna beat the shit out of somebody. This motherfucker pulled a knife on us.
It
was a sword.
A spear.
It was a goddamn Crocodile Dundee knife, a Rambo knife.
Shit. I likes that though.
It wasn't even sharp.
Cause like you said, Hebrews, what's that, 47? What is that 4:7 Hebrews
word? He just read it.
Oh, he did read it, didn't he?
Yeah, Hebrews 4:12.
Got him. It just
because the word is sharper than your sword and your knife. Because that word was cutting them up, man. We ain't even pressing with them fools, man. They ain't nobodies. Even if they would have stabbed me, they still a nobody.
Some young fools.
You know what I mean?
Young fools.
They still nobodies. You can kill us and you still are nobody. You still accomplish nothing.
They ain't no one in your experience to kill nobody.
Well, you know what I'm saying.
I'll be your homie.
Get him on camera, dude.
He
drunk out of his mind. He just playing
crazy.
What was you looking for?
Wasn't it last week he went up there and pitched?
Four. I don't know what I'm talking about. He has four. I think it's four.
Darth Vader.
Jeremiah 18:18. Then said they, come and let us devices against Jeremiah. The law shall not perish from the priest, nor counsel from the wise, nor the word from the prophet. Come and let us smite with
fingers. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Come and let us smite him with the tongue, and let us not give heed to any of his words. Give heed to me, O Lord, and hearken to the voice of them that contend with me. Shall evil be recompensed for good? But they have digged a pit for my soul. Remember that I stood before thee to speak good for them and to turn away thy wrath from them. Therefore deliver up their children to the famine and pour out their blood by the force of the sword. And let the wise be bereaved of their children and be widows. And let their men be put to death. Let their young men be slain by the sword.
Them fools right there, the Lord gonna put them dudes to death, man. Little weirdo.
Just do a search.
Let a cry be heard from their houses when thou shalt bring a troop suddenly upon them. For they have digged a pit to take me and hid snares for my feet. Yet, Lord, thou knowest all their counsel against me to slay me. Forgive not their iniquity, nor blot out their sin from thy sight. But let them be overthrown before thee. Deal thus with them in a time of thine anger.
Sounds like judgment, the scripture you just read to me. These motherfuckers think they're gonna be able to just walk around and walk the streets every day being fucking complete demons. They don't even realize judgment's coming on these fools soon. And then come out here and assault and then threaten the men of the Lord? That's a motherfucking position I don't wanna be in. First thing you learn when learning truth, when you're learning wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, is the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord. Stupid ass. He'll sober day until he get his
liquor. He just cracked a beer.
Who's that?
Dude, right here.
Oh shit.
Hey,
oh, you got check out. You got them. We got some pumas. Oh, that should do that with pissing last. He came dressed to impress us.
That's right.
He's got his pads underneath in case he falls.
Why we used to read this every week?
We slipped.
Yeah, we slipped. I guess six, bro.
It's six.
Okay. I already got it.
Oh, okay. I gotta read it just so I can help. That'll help you remember what it is. Acts 6.
Well, it starts in 6. That's right, because it goes into 7. That's when it goes into the Most High's temple, not made with human hands. Yeah.
Hey. They're not gonna be captured.
It's a long chapter, right? Let's start it. I'm gonna read this part real quick. Acts 6 and 8. And Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Because he was a man of the Lord, Stephen. But then you go into Acts 7, and then we're all the way towards the end. We might as well just read that again.
I'm going to start at 3, though. I'm going to start at 6 and 3, man.
6 and
3. Yeah. Let me just read.
But that goes all, because it don't, his death don't come to the end of 7.
That's
like 2 pages later.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's...
Let's just start at Acts 7 and 48. Because there is a lot of meat in all of it. Okay. But that would take
Acts 7 and 48. Acts 7 and 48. How did the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as said the prophet?
And this was what Stephen was telling these fools.
Heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. What house would ye build me?
So we was doing the same thing Stephen was doing. Read them the same script. That's funny, we was reading that scripture.
That's the spirit. That's
you
the
know
spirit.
What I'm saying? They out here trying to threaten us with violence. You know what I'm saying? Pull a knife on us. You know what I'm saying?
What house would ye build me, said the Lord? Or what is the place of my rest? Have not my hand made all these things? Ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Spirit as your fathers did, so do ye. Which of the prophets have not your father first persecuted?
He said, what's of the prophets did your fathers not persecute? Man, they persecuted every last one of the prophets. They threw Jeremiah in prison. They say they sawed Isaiah's head off with a saw. You know what I'm saying? Every prophet that came on the scene, everybody had a problem with it. Moses even had problems with these wicked Israelites. He had to put a bunch of them to death. You know what I'm saying? Keep going.
And they have slain them with shewed before of the coming of the just one, of whom ye have been now the betrayers and murderers, who have received the law by the disposition of angels.
Man, your boy's over here humping the pole. I'm sorry.
It's a book of Acts all over again. The great crazy motherfucking Acts. You know?
He was making out with it.
We are living what in the book. The we fuck? Are living in the scriptures again.
Yeah, this is the reincarnation,
that's
man.
That's right. The same people.
So you can't
same
tell me.
Demons, same devils.
So you can't tell me reincarnation ain't real. That's
right. You're the children of evildoers.
Oh my God.
Go ahead.
Of whom ye have been now the betrayers and murderers, who have received the law by the disposition of angels and have not kept it. When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart.
They were cut. Then when they heard these things, just like your boys that was up here, those goblin creatures, they were some weirdos too. They were some into cutting each other and shit. You see that? That one dude that was here with him at first, he had an upside down cross carved into his chest. What kind of wild, crazy demons these people have got on him, man? And he was out here with a knife, like he cutting himself. He had cut marks all over him.
Children of fools.
He said, children of fools. The actual devil worshippers. If you're going to tell me they ain't, something's fucking wrong with this shit, man.
Oh, but they're beautiful and brave because they're expressing themselves.
Oh, that's the freedom they was talking about.
That's right. That's their freedom.
That's that freedom in America. And the freedom in America, you got the freedom to worship the devil. You can worship Satan. You can carve upside down crosses in your chest. If we was back in the Bar Kingdom and someone had that shit carved on their chest, they would just get put to death on the spot.
Yeah, we're going
to get a witness. They wouldn't even have time to scab over it.
Get the witness.
Just get busy stoning that motherfucker. I'd rather get my head blown off than get stoned.
Because he said, hail Satan.
That's right.
That means he blasphemed the Lord.
That's right.
If you say hail Satan, you should not be allowed to say hail Satan. But America is the kingdom of Satan. So you in America, you're allowed to give praise to Satan. That's why the Church of Satan was founded in America, in San Francisco, by Anton LaVey, a so-called Jew. That's the vibration of America as Satanism. The Satanism is all about the lust of the flesh. That's all you see out here is the lust of the flesh, fulfilling the lust of the flesh. Keep going.
When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart, and they gnashed on them with their teeth.
Yeah, so Stephen was hitting them with scriptures, and they gnashed on him with their teeth. They were so disgusted. They wanted to kill Stephen. Just like them fools right there wanted to kill us. Keep going.
But he, being full of the Holy Spirit, looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of the Most High.
So he's seen the glory of the Most High. Keep going.
And Yahushua standing on the right hand of the Most High.
Then he see the Son of the Most High, the one they call Jesus. Keep going.
And said, behold.
Oh, yeah, right homie. There.
Yeah. Yeah, he's nuts, man. We see him all the time.
Yo, man, yeah, we've been seeing him for years,
man. Seen
him
early, man. Look.
That's why I get wild.
I'm here talking about it. Y'all want to mess
with him. He wouldn't even know what he's
doing. You don't know what we're talking about.
He wouldn't know what
he has some stockings on. Baby stockings on. Oh, yeah. He's wearing a dollar store with his face. All on his hair, man.
Last week, he was in the middle of the street pissing.
He was?
Yeah. Well, he was up there on that patio up there pissing.
We got him banging against the head. He was over at the bus stop banging his head against the ground last week too.
A couple years ago, he beat the shit out of some bitch.
Yeah, sure. Oh, he did. Yeah. Like, just so they let it back out though.
And then right back out.
Yeah, of course, because he's
lonely. Lonely.
Hey, the book of Acts all over again.
Thanks, man.
He cool though. You know, as long as you leave him
alone, cool.
Let him do his thing.
He's just, you know.
Of course, I like him. I like him out here.
Yeah, he cool. He look like,
he fits in perfect.
He like, you know, he remind me of Al Pacino. He look like a thug.
Yeah, he did.
He's like Al Pacino in real movie.
He reminds me of my old best friend that was beat to
death. Oh, shit.
He does. He reminds me perfect. Look just like him.
Yeah. He's like, just he's like, well, the guess. He's like, I ain't even got to see that.
He's like,
I love it, man.
he didn't determine to get him some pussy, boy.
Man, he can give him some too.
Yeah, he's just gonna snatch it.
Hey, when the time comes, he's gonna give him some too.
He is.
Yeah, he is. He gonna rape the hell out of some bitch while he's shitting at the same time he's fucking the bitch. He goes, man, most likely gonna put terror on his ass.
He gonna piss on the bitch.
Right, before he fuck her. Rub some on himself and shit. This is amazing. Hey, the terror of the Lord is gonna be in full effect.
We already know what's gonna happen.
Right. Here you go. But he, being full of the Holy Spirit, looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of the Most High and Yahushua standing on the right hand of Yahweh, and said, behold, I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of Yahweh. Then they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears and ran upon him with one accord.
Yeah, so they all rushed up Stephen and they just rushed him. Keep on.
And cast him out of the city and stoned him. And the witnesses laid down their clothes at a young man's feet, whose name was Saul. And they stoned Stephen, calling upon the Most High and saying, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And he kneeled down and cried with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin to their charge. And when he had said this, he fell asleep.
Yeah, so they killed Stephen because he was hitting them with the scriptures. They killed him because he was teaching them the truth. He was trying to wake those fools up. You know what I mean?
A good deed. You know?
He was doing a good deed, and they killed him for it. Just like your boys came up. And because Stephen cursed him out. He said, which one of the prophets did your forefathers not kill?
Which one?
So he wasn't speaking nice words to him. You know what I mean? He was rebuking him sharply.
Right. That's right.
Just like we was rebuking those reprobates. You know what I mean? That is pretty much devil worshipers. Did you see how fucking weird those motherfuckers were?
Freaks.
We got him on camera with a big ass knife.
Goddamn freaks.
I got him when he was slicing his arm too.
Yeah.
I had a close up on that shit.
They sit there and cut each other all day.
Right. Jacking off on each other.
Yeah, they're jacking off on each other. I told them they was scatting and skeeting all over each other.
Right.
You can tell they was, man. Them dudes were some weirdos, man.
Crazy shit.
They done did some weird shit. They doing it. But the Most High got a mark now, though. They gonna come up with that nonsense they just did. They're fucked. And they thought they gonna threaten somebody with violence. The Most High gonna show them what violence is all about. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
They like violence, they gonna get violence. You know what I'm saying?
I hope they have that knife in that day.
Yeah. Oh, they gonna need it.
That knife ain't gonna do shit.
That's gonna be worthless. Yeah, the knife ain't.
Use that word knife to try and take themselves out. Ain't gonna work.
Yep. I'll rip that little knife out of his hand and stab himself in the neck with it. Whoa, what's this guy smoking?
I'd rather hang with the crazy dude than that motherfucker on the bike.
Yeah, me too.
That motherfucker was creepy.
Even the crazy dude laughed at
him. Right.
You know that's bad.
Here you go. This is 2 Andrews 15:48. Thou hast followed her that is hated in all her works and inventions. Therefore said the Most High, I will send plagues upon thee, widowhood, poverty.
That's what's coming. That's already here. That's why we all in poverty. That's a plague from the Most High.
Mm. Poverty, famine, the sword.
Famine. He was talking about that down in Venezuela. Mm. All them Jakes down there in Venezuela. They can't even got no food. They got to get fingerprints taken and do biometrics just to eat. Keep going.
Sword and pestilence to waste thy houses with destruction and death. And the glory of thy power shall be dried up as a flower when the heat shall arise that is sent over thee. Thou shalt be weeping as a poor woman with stripes and as poor chastised with wounds, so that the mighty and lovers shall not be able to receive thee. Would I with jealousy have proceeded against thee, said the Lord, if thou hast not always slain my chosen.
Right, there goes again, the slain the chosen.
Exalting the stroke of thy hands and saying over their dead, when thou wast drunken, set forth the beauty of thy countenance. The reward of thy whoredom shall be in thy bosom. Therefore shalt thou receive a recompense.
So yeah, these fools, they gonna get their recompense, man. And it ain't gonna be nice either. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
The Lord try to be nice, but you can't be, because Israel don't respect nothing but violence and death. And they never listen until you just beat the shit out of them, fuck them up, and then they still don't want to listen.
They forget after a couple days.
Or like your boy Tupac got shot 5 times. Instead of taking that as a sign or a warning, he brags about it. Oh, I got shot 5 times.
Yeah, right, can't kill me. Right.
You know, that's the Jake spirit. These motherfuckers are full of so much damn pride. That's why the Lord's gonna bring all this death and destruction, man. He gonna beat that pride out you. You know what I'm saying? He's just gonna destroy you.
What happened?
Go ahead.
First Peter 4:12. Behold, think it, beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you.
Right.
But rejoice.
You're fucked up because they going through hard times and shit. They don't know what the hell going on, but they call themselves being in the truth. Go ahead, bro.
But rejoice in as much as ye are partakers of Christ's suffering, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy.
That's right.
If ye be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye, for the spirit of glory and of God resteth upon you. In their part, he is evil spoken of, but on your part, he is glorified. Let none of you suffer as a murderer, as a thief, or as an evil doer, or as a busybody in other men's matters. If any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on his behalf.
Right, it ain't a bad thing going through this suffering we're going through, man. It's like a badge of honor in all reality. It's a badge of honor to suffer. Going through hard times,
well, having
all
pain, doing,
all these fucking, going through this extreme oppression that we're going through.
It is bad enough, we gotta be we broke as hell, you poor, you know? Shit, ain't got shit, you gotta follow these bullshit laws, living in the satanic kingdom where you got faggots and blasphemy. You got actual devil worshippers walking around with upside down crosses carved on a goddamn chest, walking around free, blaspheming the name of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? It's bad enough we gotta deal with that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I got a precept to back up these fools out here. Leviticus 24:16. Actually, I'm sorry, 15. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel. Because that's who we sent. We sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, whosoever curseth his God shall bear his sin. And he that blasphemeth the name of the Lord, he shall surely be put to death.
That motherfucker said, hell Satan.
So people saying we can't talk shit. What the Lord himself said, if you curse the Lord, you shall surely be put to death. So you can't say we going out of bounds. We teaching the wrong message. You know,
like we out here just cussing motherfuckers out.
Just for
people.
No reason.
Right.
Just fucking with people. No, we telling you, if you curse the name of the Lord, you're going to get put to death. I mean, you know, it's what the Bible says. And he that blasphemy the name of the Lord, he shall surely be put to death. And all the congregation shall certainly stone him, as well as a stranger. And he that is born in the land, when he blasphemeth the name of the Lord, shall be put to death. That's plain and clear, man. Anybody out here blaspheming the Lord, they deserve death. Especially because you can repent. You can be a blasphemer, but once you hear this truth, like, ah, shit, I ain't gonna do that no more.
That's right.
But once you hear this truth and you still keep blaspheming the Lord, then you mark for death.
That's your ass. And it ain't gonna be pretty. Anybody y'all finish with
one? Oh, that's the point, man. That was pretty cut and clear.
Okay, here we go. This is 56, 16, 56.
Wait, just real quick. Do you guys have a good word?
Yeah, destruction to this goddamn sorry ass nation that you call America.
Yeah, America's the kingdom of Satan. The Lord gonna destroy it from off the face of the earth.
Okay. You gotta get answered.
He's like, okay.
He asked a good question, we gave him a good answer. Answer a fool to his father. You know? like as thou hast done unto my children, said the Lord. Even so shall the Most High do unto thee, and shall deliver thee into mischief.
Right, like the dude want to stab us. We shouldn't even keep talking about them. The dudes are insignificant. But he want to stab somebody, so he going to get stabbed. It, one of his boyfriend might get in an argument with him. He might shove that knife right up his asshole.
Yeah, kill each other, huh?
And stab right in his ass and twist it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep. And the wicked do that, too.
They do shit like that.
That's what you do, laying in the bed with Satan. Satan kill nobody.
He might cheat on his boyfriend or something and do some wicked shit.
Y'all seen the movie Belly?
Yeah.
When they was at the, DMX and the two niggas was at the restaurant at the table, and they got mad at each other and laid the guns on the table.
Oh, yeah.
Killed his best friend, the one he grew up with. Took him right out.
That's that movie when Nas was talking about, we gotta go back to Africa.
Oh, that dumb shit. Right. Say he got there and the air just smelled better. It smelled better. And then, you know, it stinks there. Yeah. It probably smelled worse than America, man. This place stinks.
I hated that movie just because he was in it.
The people stink. I hate Nas too.
I fucking hate Nas, man. I used to think I liked him back when Illmatic came out.
I ain't never liked that son of a bitch.
Yeah, but you know, I got off that Nas bandwagon real quick.
Nas, like saying Nas.
That Illmatic was all right, but that was just the producers making him sound good.
Right.
I don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
I do not want to hear that shit.
It's about to drop.
Well, it's going to drop all right. Right off a goddamn cliff.
Right into the gutter. Thy children shall die of hunger, and thou shalt fall through the sword. Thy cities shall be broken down, and all thine shall perish with the sword in the field. They that be in the mountains shall die of hunger, and eat their own flesh, and drink their own blood.
And they drink their own blood, and eat their own flesh. And this was coming to America. Like the brother brought out earlier, that's already going on in Venezuela and other parts of the world. Because there's a shortage of food, the economies across the world are collapsing, and then it's gonna come to America. What do you think all this civil unrest is gonna lead to? You got all these race wars popping off, we got race wars and riots, and ain't nobody going to work in Baltimore. What's gonna happen to that economy?
That shit collapse, man.
It's gonna collapse. Watch, this summer, it's gonna be a hot summer.
Did you see the Orioles game? The whole stadium was empty.
Yeah, they shut the whole thing, yeah. So they ain't getting no money for hot dogs. That's an abomination, a hot dog.
The beer they sell at the
bar. They ain't making no money off. That's where they make their money, is on the concession stands and merchandise. That's where they make all their money, that old high-priced bullshit. Okay? So what do you think is going to happen when you got riots and race wars in multiple major cities at one time?
You go to your homie.
And that's what's going to happen. What are you talking about?
Davey Hunt.
Where you see him?
Right, he's coming. He's right in the grass walking. Let's keep it going, bro. Let's keep it going. Okay, you want me to finish one?
Oh, yeah, whatever you got.
Okay, and eat their own flesh and drink their own blood for very hunger of bread. He probably would have healed, man, if he was here, man. That's a crazy day.
Look!
Oh, shit.
And thirst of water.
Look at your homie.
Unhappy shall come through the sea and receive plagues again.
You didn't see your homie?
Yeah, he's nuts, man.
And in the pastures they shall rush on the idle city and shall destroy some portions of thy land and consume part of thy glory and shall return to Babylon that was destroyed. And thou shalt be cast down by them as stubble, and they shall be unto thee as fire and shall consume thee and thy cities, thy land and thy mountains. All thy woods and thy fruitful trees shall be burned up.
That's America.
With fire.
That's what's going to happen to America. You're going to get burned up with fire. Hey, your Baltimore's already burned up with fire. But that real fire is going to come with those missiles.
They tearing that city up, too.
Hey, the fuck.
And shut don't, down. Don't forget about Missouri. That shit's still going on, too.
It's still going.
They ain't never let down.
There was you got race wars popping off all around the country. Down in South Carolina, there's groups of Jake going around beating the shit out of white people in South Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
That shit's going to be spreading, and it's going to be in every major city.
And it's definitely coming here.
And it's all by design, too.
Yeah. And Columbus, Ohio is a racist-ass place, man. It's a prejudice-ass place. When it happens here, it's gonna be some bad shit.
It's gonna be strange when we have it here.
It's gonna be some beautiful shit. I can't wait. You know what I'm saying? I'm excited. These are some exciting times we live in.
Well, tomorrow's like waiting on the Super Bowl. When they gonna announce. announce whether they're going to indict the officer or not?
They said they ain't going to know for another couple months.
Oh, they're going to make bullshit now.
But you know what? These fools can do what they want because they think they own their time. This is the most, the whole fucking, these devils on the most eyes, Tommy. Yeah, most eyes going to do what? Hey, you know what I'm saying? They can think this shit going to calm down at once. The most eyes going to just be slowly turning that faucet up more and more, man.
But even the elite, they don't want it to calm down.
Hell no.
They want this chaos so they can bring in that martial law. They gonna start rounding fools up, put them in camps. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, let me show you.
They already stashed, they been stashing motherfuckers up left and right. Hey, you missed your boy that was out here, man. Dude. You have to watch the video. Dude pulled a big ass knife out on us.
Was it serious?
Nah, he was not serious.
Oh, just talking shit.
He was just talking. He was an old little goblin creature.
Wearing a Pokemon book bag.
We had a.
Why you say it was my boy though?
No, you know, what I'm saying. Oh, boy, okay. You know, man. That's just the way that's just the way I say that.
Oh, right.
I don't know
that's your boy.
That's your boy right there.
That's your boy right there. That's your boy right there going up the cars.
Oh, that is my boy, actually.
What's up, boy?
What's up, homie?
You got some good rice coming?
Look like Bruce Lee, man. He did. What's up, homie? He might have been a Jake. He trying to come
here. Yeah, he's a Jake, man, because Jake, that normal Chinese with a mobile won't turn around, even nah. Acknowledge it. We keep going. Yeah. But Jake's just curious always, man. Always a curious cat.
Yeah, because whoever Bruce Lee family, he got a big-ass family somewhere. He come from a long line of Israelites. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You got a lot of them Chinese motherfuckers is our people, man.
Bruce Lee was getting a lot of pussy.
He got it. He was getting a lot of pussy.
A lot of pussy, man.
That motherfucker lost his way, though.
It's all right. The Most High took him out.
It was meant to be that way, though, right? It was meant to be that way.
They couldn't have his ass living too long. You know what I mean?
I don't know if y'all seen these photos online yet, but that's the Bloods and Crips in a Nation of Islam posing together.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying?
See if you get that on
that's
camera.
Cold,
it probably ain't going to pick it up.
That's all the wicked coming together.
Oh, it's too glaring.
That's the prophecy. They're number prophecy, man.
The Latin Kings.
No, oh, they ain't getting it.
They came together with them, too.
So that proves that in the Nation of Islam, they're not godly people.
Hell no.
They claim that they're godly people. But they linking up with gangsters who call themselves gangbangers to sell drugs, shoot motherfuckers. What Nation of Islam are drug dealers? Then you said he knew the Nation of Islam motherfuckers.
Yeah, I was always around.
They were selling dope.
Of them. Yeah, one of the ones I was always, around a lot. This motherfucker was always trying to do dirt, man. You know what I'm saying? I went to his crib one day. These motherfuckers got weed being delivered through the mail and shit.
Well, even
you know what I mean? He's just a no good nigga, man. And plus, he was a fag.
That's why you.
A fag, yeah. He was a Nation of Islam.
Going back, that's even why your boy Malcolm X was exposing the asses.
Right. This motherfucker in the Nation of Islam, but on his back, his whole back is covered by the Virgin Mary and shit. Actually, Semiramis and Tammuz on a cross or some shit on his back.
That's proof they are not godly people.
Right.
But what's up with that bow tie shit?
Feeling forward.
Oh, they all wearing bow ties, little red bow ties.
Right, gay ass bow ties.
Who the fuck, you ain't gonna get me to wear no red bow tie. Look like Pee Wee Herman. You know what I'm saying?
That's one of them demons that the Most High gonna release. That's down there in Boston. That's a demon being walking around down there. But Most High,
it looks like
come a time, you gonna put these motherfuckers through.
It looks like your boy,
these demons,
boy
man.
Denzel on that movie with the demons. What was that movie?
You talking about, Dale.
I
was my,
I just remember they had that Rolling Stones.
Yes, I love that movie.
Time was on my side.
Yeah, right. The demon in that movie was Azazel.
Was it too? Oh, shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a heavy demon.
Yeah.
That's a demon from the Book of Tobit, ain't it?
Right. Yep.
Oh, no, that was Asmodeus.
Asmodeus, yeah.
That's when the
going around.
Oh, Azazel, that's
touch him, it leaves me and go to you. The demons just go passing through, motherfuckers.
Right now, though.
The movie is called
Sometime.
But man, can you imagine when shit break loose, you see a bunch of them walking around, man, coming after your ass? You gonna turn the other way.
And two thirds is gonna get caught out there.
Yeah, you're gonna turn the other fucking way, man. And that's a grimy looking motherfucker too.
Cause you know,
a grimy motherfucker, man. Another, you can see, look at that nigga, man.
Another thing too.
Look at the expression on his face.
A man of the Lord ain't supposed to be going out.
You see the police car burning in the background and shit. Yeah.
That proves supposed to be out there riding, burning shit down.
They destroyed thousands and thousands of dollars.
Hell no, that's for two. That's two thirds of fun time. Mm-hmm. That's not for us.
That's not right. Thank you, bro. That's important to get that out there. That's for them.
That's two thirds.
That's right.
And what's gonna happen to them? They gonna start using real bullets soon. They said they hit them with tear gas, maybe rubber bullets. Soon they gonna start using real bullets. They gonna start mowing motherfuckers down. Why? Cause Jay gonna get so bold, they gonna think we can do whatever we want. They gonna let us.
Yeah.
That's what's gonna happen. Then they gonna watch. They gonna bring down the hammer. Martial law. That's when them camps come into play. We already know it, man. They found the script perfect. And we've been saying this shit for years.
Yeah, that was all set up how the mayor told the police to stand down. So these people can have free reign.
Oh yeah, the mayor did.
You know what I'm saying? They want them to do that.
That's right, that's right. So that time going to come when, man, I'm telling you, these motherfuckers gonna think, oh, all right, let's just go to all these shopping centers. I need me a flat screen TV. You know, they gonna get busy, man. And I got another picture.
It's a setup.
Down there in Boston, where there's thousands of motherfuckers coming between a building, and they ain't done but like 30, 40 police. Image yourself, man, was like, God damn, these cops don't even know what's coming for
them. Yeah, the cops gonna get fucked up.
I mean, it was literally 100,000 people coming down the street.
They said over 100 cops already got injured. Over 100.
Yeah.
A couple of them in critical condition.
Yeah,
it's gonna be bad, man. But like I said, we out here warning the ungodly and the so-called few. But hey. Why do you think they gonna get such an ass with them, man? Because they ignored the word.
So why that happening with your ass?
I'm gonna be at home.
We ain't gonna be out there.
We might end up. The Lord is funny, man. He got strange ways how he set shit up, man. Might all end up together somewhere.
He gonna put you right where he wants you.
That's right. That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right. But I don't.
You ain't supposed to be out here robbing. Because you'll have some people like. Like, a dude who was in our camp, Dave.
Mm-hmm.
The one day he stole some shit and said he did it in the name of the Lord.
Oh, Lord. He's like, you remember that shit, man?
Come on, black dude.
Yeah. But then he said. You ain't never
met. No, not him. The other one. The one that you said that was with you when you was pissing out that.
Long time ago. Yeah, but it was a long time ago.
There's a woman that boy he cussed out that. She was like a congresswoman.
Yeah.
You know, because they.
The one time he stole some shit, though. And he tried to justify it saying, well, I stole from an Edomite. You know what I mean? Because you'll have a lot of Jakes think they can do that. You ain't supposed to be stealing from nobody.
More likely it was an Israelite.
Yeah, it probably was a Jake you stole from.
Because Dave wasn't spiritual in the least bit.
We ain't supposed to be stealing, robbing, killing, none of that.
Yeah, so we ain't supposed to be out there, man. You know, let me put it this way, man. There's nothing in this fucking world I want anyway. I don't want a new car.
Nope.
I'm a biker, I ride motorcycles, I don't want a new bike. I don't even want no more bitches.
Only thing you supposed to ask?
I want some pussy though.
When you say the Lord's Prayer.
Right, right.
When you say the Lord's Prayer, what do you ask for? The Lord said to ask for your daily bread.
That's right.
That's it.
More wisdom, knowledge, and understanding.
I get that Isaiah 33:6.
What did Solomon ask for? You know? What did he ask for?
He didn't ask for riches.
Didn't ask for none of that worldly shit, man.
Oh.
And just like now, man, and the Lord, you know, as my witness, you know, I'm sincerely, I don't want nothing in this world. But he'll give you shit just, you know, he'll just give you shit anyway. Because he's always spoiled me, man. I gotta admit it, man. Hey, you know, Most High always spoiled me, man.
Right.
He gave me shit that he knows that I don't give a fuck about any fucking way. Because you know what? The ungodly hate to see you with shit, too.
Yeah.
You know, they see you with shit, they want to take it from your ass, you know. I don't give a shit about it. I gave up a lot for this truth, man. I can be out there running the streets, chasing bitches, doing wheelies and shit on bikes and shit, man. But, man, that's polluted garbage. It's all polluted shit. Fucking all. Fucking all.
Yeah, read that.
But I take claim of that thick one on the left.
That's how you do it.
You're like, shit, I'm still a man, too.
Damn right.
You know?
Hey, man.
You know? fuck I think that thing is.
Because a lot of Israelites going to be getting put to death. So we're going to have to get busy. You know, we're going to be having a... When this thing goes down, when we get in the kingdom, we're going to have a lot of sex.
Bring you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
That's how we're going to bring Israel back.
Two-thirds back. I know they're going to get back, though.
Right.
You know, walk out the seas.
Well, it ain't going to be a small nation of Israel in the kingdom.
The black queen will lay her stinking ass down, and they're just going to become flying.
So we finna populate the entire galaxy. We going to other planets.
That's right.
How you going to populate the entire universe? Man, you got to be fucking a lot of bitches, man.
Man, I was just looking at Jupiter yesterday, man. Just dreaming. We're going to be there.
Right. Yeah, go to Jupiter.
It's fine. I can't show
you.
It's more likely...
You're going to be jogging on Saturn's rings like it's a track. They're tracking fields.
It's over there somewhere.
Yeah, skating on it.
Let me read that Isaiah real quick.
Isaiah 33:6.
Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability.
Hold on a second, man. Loud ass shit. Go ahead.
Isaiah 33:6. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, the strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord is his treasure.
Yeah, that's our treasure, is the fear of the Lord. Not widescreen TVs, motherfucking.
Widescreen? You mean big screen?
Big screen, widescreen, 1080p.
That shit is tight, though.
Well, now they got 4K TVs.
Right. Yeah. Oh, Lord, Edwards, you kidding me, right?
You know the 4Ks?
At the end of the day, all that don't mean shit.
I got it.
Because, you know, the electric going to get cut off anyway.
They're going to shut everything
down.
They
use none of that shit.
I still got an old-ass TV with the tubes and all that in it. Yep, I ain't got a flat screen.
I got old-ass screen TVs, too.
But, you know, once martial law hit, they going to shut the internet down.
Shut it down. I'm surprised they ain't shut it down already.
Because all
them fools over there in Boston, they rely on the internet to communicate.
You mean Baltimore?
What'd I say?
Boston.
that's coming to Boston next.
Second time you said Boston.
Boston, they start with B's. Think about the Boston bombing. Because they be using Instagram and Facebook to, we're going to link up at this spot. You know what I'm saying?
Right. You see that bitch that got arrested.
And they all get monitored, too.
Right. You see that bitch that got arrested today that posted on Facebook, kill the cops or some shit. They went to that.
They gonna get her.
They went immediately to this black bitch's house.
Every last person that posted on Facebook, Instagram.
Remember I was telling you about, that was an experience. Last week, telling you keep your ass, don't be posting shit on Facebook.
Facebook's set up by the CIA.
I know this dude that works for the CIA. All he does is sit there and monitor Facebook all day.
They got thousands of them doing that. Thousands of them.
That's a lot of motherfuckers they put on their shit list.
And they be disguising, like a beautiful bitch profile. Like, you think she cute, so you add her as a friend. That's really the CIA.
Well, they can see everybody's profile anyway, so.
Yeah, right. Remember, you got local governments.
Facebook works for them anyway, because when the Facebook CEO interviewed, when he was interviewing him, he asked him what the fuck was on his back. It was like a certain symbol of the icons Facebook had.
I believe it. There's a lot of videos on it.
That's the type of symbolism.
Yeah, because you know the head of Google.
And all the people that work for Facebook wear that shit.
You know the creators of Google are all so-called Jews. The creator of Facebook's a so-called Jew. You know what I'm saying?
Zuckerberg.
And I seen some rabbis today. I was driving. They was at Lev's Pawn Shop. You know Lev. Yeah. Well, you know they own it. They was going to get they cut.
That's right.
Because if you got to pay, they got paid the rabbi 10%. If everything they make go to the rabbi. Yeah. And then they can.
You don't know ain't no rabbi in there pawning that. I need some money.
They get a cut.
Right.
And plus they'll have, you're not allowed to, if you're a so-called Jew, you're not allowed to have no business. They have the rabbi come in and bless your business. You know what I mean? But I'll cry. I was driving by. I was like, "What's up, Esau?" But they were some creepy looking motherfuckers,
man. Yeah.
I mean, they had it was all black with their sorcerer hats on. They look, you know, them big ass hats. Yeah. They look like the Undertaker, bro. You know what I'm saying?
All bears and shit.
Look like death. They look like death.
Right. They is death, really.
I'm surprised your bitch ain't out here today.
Where is your bitch at?
Man, she's always out here.
She'll be out here.
She's always out here.
I got her number. gonna hit her up.
For real?
Nah, yeah, I do got a number.
You take that bitch home and say, you don't get no bitch like that. You tell that bitch, man, let's go home. You don't talk stupid shit. You tell bitches like that, come on, let's go home, let's take a shower together. They want to hear something like this, man.
They like that shit. Man, plus, hey, a lot of bitches be telling me they like that dominant shit, bro. They want to be dominant. Man,
you know?
I spoke to a prostitute yesterday, man. She was talking hot with me.
Let him do his thing. Last week
we saw that coming. It was just a matter of time.
And look, they ain't gonna fuck with him either.
Mm-mm, of course not.
Yeah, I talked to that prostitute, man. She was talking about how if only women out here these days could meet guys like you.
Wow.
Righteous men like you. We need to get in order. We need to get ourselves in order and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Bitch need a man, man. We want to set them bitches right, man, because the women lost their understanding.
Well, we always said we got
them bitches straight.
We got more respect for prostitutes than some of these regular
Right.
Because a lot of these bitches is prostitutes. Mm-hmm. Because that's the only way they can eat.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. That don't give them a pass or nothing. But.
All right, right.
Or some no good ass wicked nigga turns them on to dope.
Yep, turn them down dope.
You know, and they naive, and women are stupid.
They are.
Let's be honest. Women are clueless.
Right.
Naive, gullible. So, as long as it make a woman feel good, a woman is down with anything.
Right.
Anything, man.
Yeah.
I was trying to get to this woman.
Selling our men, women.
And when bitches get on dope, it's way harder for them to get off of it.
Because remember Tito, right? This crackhead I grew up with. He told me that, man, there comes a time, man, I'll be out here for a week, 2 weeks. I got to go home and lay down. But my girl keep on going, and he said that she literally be out there like a zombie. She don't know how to think, talk, walk. She don't know when to go piss or shit. This is what he was telling me.
Damn.
That she just keeps going, man. He said he got to snatch her off the street and get violent with her to make her go wash her ass. You know what I mean? Just to go lay down for a minute. And then she's still fighting with him. Like, I just got to be out there. Don't know when to stop. Don't know when to fucking stop, man. But it's a woman, though. That's a woman. And like the scripture says,
they the weaker vessel.
Right. They that lead thee causeth thee to err. And that's the women. Most I created a weird ass fucking thing. Like you said, a woman shall surpass a man. Man, he meant that, man. And that's why we all destroyed. Because of these damn women. There ain't no goddamn home structure because of the damn woman. But they'll blame it on the man. That nigga was cheating on me. He was no good. He wasn't taking care of business.
You know what? They get that shit. That's one of their favorite excuses. Oh, I'm gay because I was getting treated wrong by this man. And caring all, man. I don't give you no goddamn excuse to be a faggot.
Want
to
eat some pussy.
Right.
Yeah.
That's how it is, bitch.
That's just how it is, man.
Beauty.
What am I looking for?
Isaiah 3, he's looking for? You talking about data is lead causing
error? Nah, not that. I'm looking for something else. Oh, let me just jump straight to the fucking. Here you go.
That's how your girl we was talking to last week. She said that she ain't never putting drugs.
There you go, right there. Exactly what we was talking about.
She said she is the druggiest of all the girls.
Hey, the bitch is smart, but she
ain't that smart doing heroin.
Yeah,
oh yeah, she's smart, but
yeah, she did know some shit. I kind of surprised her.
Right.
Yeah, she did grow up.
Look, your dude's hollering at them little girls. You know, he's about your head now.
Dad had money. Was dad was a.
Yeah, I saw that video. She said her ass was like an Amish for 8 months or some shit.
Yeah. Yeah, she was. She said she's on an Amish plantation or something.
Right.
She had been there because she said them Amish some weirdos. They're weird ass people, man.
They is.
God damn, that bitch thick, man. Damn.
You didn't know what to do with that anyway.
Oh, man, I'm a professional. When it comes to these hoes, you are verifying very few motherfuckers that can fuck with me, man.
Hey.
When it comes to some hoes.
Right.
When it comes to dog, not dogging them, but treating them the way they're supposed to be treated. You know, I ain't nice, man. I'm nice, but I ain't nice.
Right.
Even when I'm being nice to you, to these bitches, man, I'm being manly.
Manly.
You know what I'm saying? Look at that. Whose is that? Who owns that one? Look at that. Look at that, man. Instead of black, now it's green. in the jungle snatching.
Oh, yeah.
She got, she been different.
She switched it up. That's still out of order, man. That's out of order. Because we ain't supposed to be able to see these bitches. I can see everything.
What you mean? Like, you talking about wearing their skirt?
They supposed to wear a dress.
You can still see the ass, for real.
Well, you can see the ass.
I saw a Muslim.
Like, you can't see the camel toe.
Right, right.
Yeah, I mean,
that's some whole shit.
I can see the bitch's pussy right now. You know what I'm saying? You can see it. I can see the dimples on her ass cheeks. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Damn, it looked delicious too. Did it? It looked delicious.
But see, that, but that's what that causes adultery and all kind of shit.
Yeah, right. Well, like that's wrong
that shit. Just a real man gonna see it. He likes that ass.
Right.
That causes adultery.
It causes brothers to look at a brother to be mad at another brother and shit, you know?
Yep, because they start fighting over the pussy. You got a cock blocker coming through.
Right. Let me ask you a question, though. Should I just, because I was
talking to this Muslim, so I was like, God. She's actually an Israelite. She's Brazilian or whatever.
Right.
She's a Muslim machine. I'm trying to get her to understand that.
No. Leave it alone. Don't even entertain the thought.
If she get interested and start asking questions,
she did.
Just tell her you Muslim.
Leave it alone.
No, don't say that.
Leave it alone until you get the ones.
But she can't do that, cause in their belief, they believe that a woman ain't supposed to fuck with a man that's
not. You talking about Muslims?
Yeah.
Oh man, I've been fucking that's Muslims all the time. When I was one of the motherfuckers, I used to be
a. I told her, I was like, well, that's like in the.
Well, the Bible,
an Israelite woman can't fuck with a heathen either, though. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to let her know that the shit that y'all have right now, that y'all saying that's in y'all's Quran, is the same thing. No, like the Hebrew Bible came out way before y'all shit came out.
You know, if the bitch, if you think it's possible, you can get some ass, man, front like you is.
No, don't do that.
You can,
don't ever do that.
You don't go around saying that lie. No, I'm just saying.
Right?
You know, just like I said, keep that shit away from that bitch, man.
Because what he's trying to tell you, though, is these bitches, you can't teach them nothing, man.
Nothing.
You can't. There's not one woman that you're going to be able to teach.
Especially if it ain't your woman.
And she's already your woman. Man, the only thing I can tell you is to tell your bitch not to eat pork. That's a must. Your woman cannot eat pork. And it's just keep the Sabbath. I mean, stuff like that.
I got one wife.
So what do you need? It's more than one woman in this world. You asking for
my brother-in-law right there. Right? No, I don't
want to read. They family.
Like a seven and it's five. Trust ye not in a friend, put ye not confidence in a guy. Keep the doors of thy mouth from her that lieth in thy bosom.
There you go.
That's a good one.
There you go.
It's
simple, man. Don't tell her what's going on. Keep her in the dark about every guy. Lie to her about everything.
You can do that shit?
Yeah. Lie to her about everything.
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 You don't want to tell her.